Yeah, here we are at Mondo Video in one of my favorite sections, the Manson Mania section. They got one of the best collection of Manson videos here. Charles Manson, superstar. What more can be said about that? Cult of the Damned, loosely based on Charles Manson. Manson, which is like, got a bunch of his followers, but not him in it because he was like, you know, hot stuff behind bars. Manson interviewed by Ronald Reagan, you know, Manson's... country music, all kinds of good stuff here. Appropriately, right next to the Pimps and Hookers section. And then we pass the Godzilla section, the sci-fi, the Beast from Hell section. Oh, Dario Argento, good Christian man. I like him. Russ Meyer, what more can be said about Russ Meyer? Guy who definitely influenced me. Goddess Bunny, one of the most talented paraplegic transvestites here in Hollywood. And right here, let's see, one of my favorite sections right here is, I'm lost, is the, there it is, the Dukey Flyswatter section. Appropriately, right by the enticing anima sections. In fact, if it's okay, I'm going to put a couple anima movies right here in my section. Praise God. Yeah, and I understand you just got in this movie that's been banned for a long time. And this is one of the first movies I wrote that was produced called Blood Diner.
Banned in 29 countries.
Yeah, that's almost more than Mark of the Devil.
Why was it banned?
Just basically because I think it was probably good business to ban it in about 29 countries so it would make more money in the three countries that would show it. And probably because it was just completely offensive, you know. A lot of people got French fried. There was you know, it was like a lot of things I do. It was politically incorrect.
Why is that?
Because it seems that the things that are the most challenging, the most fun to do, that stretch you more as a performer, that are the lowest common denominator and the most gratifying, don't jive a lot with polite society.
Just a little bit here. And here, and a little bit there.
God, I must look a mess.
On the contrary, you look good enough to eat.
Ooh.
There's just one last little spot that I have to get.
Oh.
Let's see, I did my first little brief role in this movie called The Tomb. Basically, I got a line that goes, the lamb's tongues are very good today. An Egyptian waiter, once again, that Egyptian theme running in through there. Surf Nazis Must Die, which is like turned into somewhat of a cult film. I played Mangala in this picture.
Oh, man, we had a great afternoon. Look at this stuff. A whole city block was in ruins. Just like one big shopping mall. Oh, it's great. Oh, man, I feel so good. I got some drill bits, and we got some...
Money?
No.
You mean, man, this is money in the bank. Why don't you have some of the Nazi youth have a garage sale or something? This is
How are we supposed to live?
Man, I just, like, procure this stuff. Like, I don't...
But then any rational stuff.
You know, you need to lead a more Spartan life anyway.
No. You're beautiful when you're angry, Adolf.
I was in The Fisher King, too, but snip, snip, cutting room floor.
Oh, really?
You know, the same old actor's nightmare. And just did a lot of stuff like that. And right now I'm about to direct for the first time. I wrote a picture called No Mo Clothes for Whitey, which has got, like, the first picture that's got an all-nude white cast with black actors' voices dubbed in. This is me actually not looking like this. This is like prior to the Dukey Flyswatter persona, where I was actually on a game show Name That Tune, and I won fabulous prizes with my musical knowledge. Yes, almost won the giant big prize, but I was beat out by a 7'2" born again Christian woman with 20 kids, and that's tough odds for anyone to beat.
Oh, I got it. You didn't run up and kiss him or anything.
The New York State. Against the Jack of all trades in Los Angeles.
And they thought I was
the Jack of all trades from Los Angeles.
Basically, I was like in between jobs and acting jobs and looking for something to do. So I said, well, screw it, I'll go on a game show. And I did, and I got on. And
you look so straight.
I know, and they thought I was weird. I had these pointy shoes on. The cameraman kept on looking at my shoes and everything like that. So I was like, I guess no matter what you look like, if you feel weird inside or radiate differentness, it comes off, and people will take off on that. And I guess part of that is still here, you know. I'm still that kind of like normal guy who can get on a game show and stuff like that. But I guess it doesn't serve as much purpose in my life anymore. Bronson Canyon, this is kind of a sacred space, both to Hollywood and both to people that are like, you know, come here personally to get away from like the city, which is just about 10 minutes down. And they blew out this mountain in the 20s to like make a lot of movies here. And here is where I saw a lot of the movies that influenced me as a kid, you know, like The Lone Ranger, they shot here. And stuff like, you know, Vampire Women from Outer Space and It Conquered the World and the Batman TV series and stuff like that. You know, a lot of stuff that was like important to kids growing up in America here. You know, I come here to be alone a lot and stuff like that. And I'll disappoint a few people. We'll drop this mask at least. And I come here a lot too to forget about like, you know, the bullshit about like being my goals and stuff like that, you know, just about being a star and or whatever it is I think I want or whatever. And I'll just come here a lot to like, I guess, kind of like to listen and meditate.
How did you get interested in the sort of different stuff that you're into?
I guess from feeling different, you know, from other people's reaction to me that as a kid, you know, you feel like you're separate, like you're picked on and stuff like that. I was kind of like, you know, the fat kid, the weird kid and stuff like that. And so I ended up spending a lot of time at home and trying to figure out different ways to fit in and becoming interested in movies and stuff like that. And after a while, you know, and if anything makes you come to grips with where you feel in your place in the world and everything like that, because I look different too, I'm really unusual. A lot of people made it a point of telling me that.
Oh, yeah.
Which is easier to reconcile with as an adult and not so easy to reconcile with when you're like about 6 years old. And so I guess after a lot of people saying, you know, you're different, that's what you try for. That's what you pretty much figure out your niche is. But so in a way, that can be kind of like an escape. But in another way, it also is like puts a big challenge on you, you know, also, and becomes you learn different things and go different places where maybe other people don't go, and like being different, and you find out the value there, or whether there's any value at all.